What's going on?
All right, we're back and on cue, I say.
Yeah.
What are we talking about?
I don't know. Yeah.
That's awesome. Oh, check it out.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's not bullets. But it's hot enough to beat bullets.
Yeah.
Boom!
Yeah.
I'm either gonna. Every time I come over here, I have these big dreams of making it big when you go to.
Delusions of grandeur.
Sure, absolutely is what we're gonna call them. Because they are.
Well, yeah.
It's not gonna come to fruition.
No, but.
My goal is to not get booed off.
Right.
If they laugh, I can go back and say, hey, I actually went over there and did a club, and people laughed.
Right.
And then I got to hang out with some folk afterwards, and they had a good time. I wasn't booed off or nothing. Like, they like it. That, to me, would be would be great, man. Otherwise, it would be like, damn, I wasn't funny all along. I'm just saying.
Right,
I'm being honest, you know?
Delusions of
grandeur. Maybe I wasn't that funny all along. Maybe Steve is loaded or something.
Right.
But I think they'll like it, you know what I'm saying? Like, the same little stick without some of the harsh stuff
I do
for my mom's cousins. Like, they're my second cousin, but they're older. Yeah. And they love, like, and I do about the church and stuff like that. Because ever since I was 16, I would do these impressions of some of the people from our church. And mom would love it, you know?
Yeah.
You have Doug coming by hugging the women 2 or 3 times.
No, but that's cool.
No. But that's the truth, man. Like, my aunt Sylvia and Cheryl, even in back in the day, especially like mom, Shelly, my dad's sister Shelly, begged mom one time when I was like 16. She said, please take him to like the juvenile stand up they would have at the comedy clubs in Charlotte. And I didn't do it, man. I was just nervous. I didn't want to do it. But I was, my whole stick was just talking about the church scene. My mom didn't like it at first, but Shelly ate it up. She's like, that is hilarious, bro.
Oh, yeah.
That's so funny.
I heard you.
We had Georgie Moose, whose pocketbook smelled like candy. And if you were new to the church and your baby cried, she'd go grab your baby. like she's stealing it, but yet it's being taken care of like it's King Herod as a child in the back. You know? Like, the way it was in the culture. Somebody died, we ate. I knew somebody had passed, but my mom was on the phone and say, well, let me make a casserole. And Papa would say, well, somebody died. And then she'd hang up, Roy, guess he passed away.
Right.
And he would be, you know.
Oh, no.
But that's the culture. Like my mom's, you'd sit with the casket all night long.
Right,
I don't know why, but you did. They brought it to the house, unloaded it in the living room, and there you go for 24 hours.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Then you'd have a wake, and then whatever.
Sure.
Yeah. But not to be like downer, but just the cultural stuff, like the holidays. Like you're like, because you're Jewish, half Jewish, and you get like, I want to try matzo balls. I want your mom's matzo balls.
Oh, boy.
Is what I want. That is like.
Look out, everybody. 2021.
You're bringing a redneck to the table.
Well,
is that a high holiday?
Well, I'm going to take you to California. I'm going to go to, you can go back to North Carolina. And I go up to Washington State for Samantha's graduation, but I can, company.
What now?
Loans you the money,
But what are we doing?
I'll go fly to San Diego.
We never talked about splitting off. We'll make it 2022 then.
Well, okay, but
we're not dipping off. You've got prior. I told you, that's more important.
2021 is when Samantha graduates.
Yeah. Well, there's two parts of the deal. A, I got the money and you stay with me. B, as long as there's no prior commitments. And you got a prior commitment, so I can put it off to 2022.
Thank you.
Yes. No, I don't want you leaving, man.
It'll be 2023.
No, there's no 2023. 2020, no, hell no, there's no 2023. I don't even want to put it off, but I even told you after her holiday or after she graduates, if I had the money and it don't cost you a dime, I would love for you to be able to take a vacation so I could do it. That's what I wanted, you know?
Every now and then I get down to the end of the day, I'll
Because mom's like, well, why don't you pay for me, Dad? I'm like, because you know what? Mom, basically, you don't smoke weed. And by then, it might be on the table here to be legal, but it might be up there, and I would like to try. I'm just saying, that was the discussion today between all of the bums, man, you know, and Fletcher.
Right, yeah.
By the way, Fletcher's got a big, it looks like Run DMC out with a big necklace. I'm like, come on, man. You know, Rock the Bells, I can understand back in the day when it was right, a big thing, but come on, man.
Well, he's had a hard summer.
He even told me. I asked him, I said, did you do it? I've done some bad one last week when his cable broke. And then when I seen it down, I'm like, Fletch, you still ain't fixed that cable. He's like, man, I ain't got the money, really. Because he gets off the same time I do, January. And I'm like, proud of him, you know what I mean? And he had a hard one. But I'm like, he's like, Eddie, you got to do what you got to do. I said, who you telling? I said, I know exactly what you're talking about, Fletcher. Honest to God, I know what you're talking about. Do what I can do with what I got. You know, and just try to make it. And I said, did you get anything done today? He said he had two and maybe one more. It was just a quick mow. And I made him laugh. I said, oh, a mow and blow. He's like, yep, a mow. He said, I said, I would quote a mow and blow. If I was you in your business thing, quote a mow and blow. You know, the street rate, $30, whatever.
That's me, I forgot that.
Yeah. And he's like, he'd never heard it. And he's like, that's good. I'm like, yeah, man. That's where you have a lot of these, landscape companies that compete for the medians in different areas, like not affiliated with the interstate, obviously, but like near your hot shots where they got the greenery and stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, you want that kind of stuff. A little patch of grass, mow and blow, clean up shrubs, you're good. Get out. Go do the next one down the road.
Oh, yeah.
My cousin, he had a company that would have been good, but.
Yeah.
Oh, well. Yeah. Cheryl helped him with that.
Right.
She loaned him like 20 grand.
Wow.
I know.
Money.
Yeah, he never paid it back.
You kidding?
Nope.
That's a damn shame.
That's why she bought these. She told me, that's how that happened. She called me. She's like, your mama said you need less. I said, yeah. And I said, who you telling? I said, no. She's like, she just told me. She's like, look, I told your mama I might go and have, but look, I'm going to tell you. She's like, I want to buy you some glasses. And I'm like, Charles, they're high. My glasses. Just for my glasses, the lenses, the type of eyes I have, it's going to be almost $1,000. And she's like, Eddie, I don't care. They turned out to be rather expensive. And Cheryl was like, swipe my card and I want him to have the best, best thing I have. Yeah. You know what? Let's throw in another pair. And she did. So, and the reason she did that was because I never asked her for money.
Right.
Never asked to borrow nothing like that. Mike has, Bradley has. Michael, my other cousin, has Tommy. I just never. She let me mow her yard though last year,
right?
Which is good. Like my first, you know, the year before. But. She can't drive on this yet.
No.
Yeah, this is the unrated version. Yeah, she can't drive. She's like a dude's hazard coming out of the Walmart.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, Cheryl, we were on two wheels. She's like, I didn't even see that curve, honey. I'm like, thank God it wasn't a body we ran over.
Yeah.
I'm like, can you stop? Like, immediately stop. I said, stop. Yeah. Stop. Please stop. Because I had to check the wheels, make sure the hubs weren't bent.
Oh, yeah.
Things looked, it's like, that's how hardly it. And she's like, didn't even know. I'm like, well, I just jarred my back about the second, third vertebrae. How did you not know? You know? I'm telling you, the first time it dipped to 60, she's got the gas man over there looking at her fireplace.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to sweat your 8LS off up at Thanksgiving at her house. Because she's going to have the fire roaring. Like it's a frigid February, January night, you know? No.
Yeah.
We ain't even bust 60 hardly consistently enough for that. But she'll do it, though.
Yeah. And all the other Thanksgiving, Christmas.
You know where you'll be.
No, man, I want to at least go see the one little hussy in the house.
We need to do that, man, because once we get our lights up, we all mingle. We need to go look at that.
Yeah, little hussy in the house.
I need to go talk to him because it's been years since I was a kid. Yeah. They just say, hey, I got to, you know, kind of feel that house. Yeah. I don't have, because there's a lot of times I walk by the tenement house or the car wash, the chiropractor or whatever it is next to the other house by the soup kitchen or the one by the soup kitchen.
Yeah.
I often want to walk up and say, hey, I grew up in this house. Can I look inside?
Yeah.
And I don't really know how to approach. And as a kid growing up on that block, I've stayed all hours of the night in every single house except that one by the Mexican restaurant.
Yeah.
I never went into that one, ever. Everything else, like Miss Cone was my nursery. Yeah. I got a picture of me and Mike in 1978, something like that. And this Hannah Wyatt, whose dad owned a Porsche shop over there behind the Bojangles, where it was at.
Yeah.
Connie Engel, me, Dirt. Mike, we were just kids,
Oh, yeah.
And Miss Cone. Then when she got older and I was like in the third or fourth grade, I would see Miss Cone pulling into the one-way, take that fire hydrant out, just keep on going. But she lived by Miss Parker on that same street by the road up. Miss Parker would pull up, she's in her 90s, and she'd hit cars in the front and back of her. And Mom would pick stuff out of the garden and extend it all the way down past. The yard extends down to that other house that we built there. It wasn't there before.
Right.
And our garden was there.
Yeah.
So we picked vegetables out of the garden, and Mom would have me run vegetables to Miss Parker.
Okay.
And it would take her like 20 minutes to come to the door because of her wheelchair, unless Mamie was working. Mamie was her black nurse that worked with her until she died.
Right.
Her and Mr. Parker.
Yeah.
And she would tell me all the time, she'd blame Mamie. Because Mamie rolled Mr. Parker out one night or one afternoon for them to sit out front. It's that house that looks like something from Psycho on Academy.
Okay.
It's about six houses before the yellow one, over there on the right.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? By the speed hump, basically. It sits way up on, way steps up. Like, you got steps go way up.
Yeah,
well, she rolled Mr. Parker out, and they had been arguing for years.
Right.
And Mamie turned around to go get Miss Parker, and apparently she didn't leave Mr. Parker's brake on, and he rolled down those steps.
See,
it killed him.
That's like one of those movies. Yeah.
No, that's a true story though, because I can remember bringing Miss Parker the vegetables after Miss Parker died, and she would always ask me, do you want some cream? And that was ice cream. And I would say, I'm not hungry. Mamie would come in and say, you sure enough ain't got to be hungry to eat no cream.
Yeah, man.
And so they'd make me some ice cream, and I would give them the vegetables. And Petey was the little chihuahua that was like Cujo. You couldn't get
Cujo,
3 feet within her bed without him screaming, going crazy. But I could sit in her bed because Miss Parker knew me. And then after Miss Parker died, like Mamie would go fix the ice cream, Miss Parker would say, you know she killed. She would say his name like Howard.
Oh, man.
And I'm like, I know. But see, she was a smart woman though. She was part. She was one of the first women inducted to the Charlotte, Iredale, and every county around here, Better Business Bureau. She was a part of the Women's Business Association. Like, she was always in the paper. Like, very intelligent woman. But it was like, it was almost like, I hate to say it, but like the Help, the movie, the way they were, and that's the way she was. This is in the 80s, you know.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, Miss Combs, Miss Parker tears some cars up on
Academy
Street. Miss Parker was, or Miss Combs was old when she, when I was in nursery school. I have memories of that.
Right. Yeah.
She would tell us to twiddle our thumbs.
Yeah.
And then when we went to the bathroom, I swear to you guys, we just didn't go to RJ Reynolds when I was older.
Right.
Hell, I'm using the bathroom with so-and-so, Connie, or whoever, or Hannah, because you had a urinal for the boys and a toilet for the girls, and you went in boy and girl at a time, two by two. Yeah, man. You couldn't get away with that now for nothing.
Not even
now. I'd sit there meantime. Hannah's on, whatever, we ain't thinking about it. Because we were, this is the South, my God. This is the kind of shit, I'm telling you, that is the truth that I could do it to stand up. You can't make this up.
No, you lived it.
I had a crush on my first friend in nursery school. Lo and behold, we got a piss in front of each other. Fast forward 4 years later, we're RJ Reynolds and she's still looking good. I go and visit it with a pack of cigarettes rolled up in my shirt like I'm Bowser from Silent Hill. And I'm not but like 11.
Of course.
No wonder I'm smoking like crazy. Robin flipped out though. Oh, by the way, their son gets out Sunday.
Who?
Michael.
Oh boy.
Robin and him son.
Oh no, so what's even like Terror and Fear on South Academy Street?
Terror's no. He's I think he's going somewhere. He's got to go to a halfway house. He's on parole.
Right, yeah, I'm on.
He had extensive facial reconstructive surgery because he owed money to some of the gangs. Right before he got processed into another one, they beat the hell out of him.
Right.
Yep, yep. And 2 years ago, he got his face reconstructed because of the CEOs.
Right,
shut out.
Else.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. This come off the album of Don't Come Around Here No More. Because I remember this video on MTV.
Right, yeah.
It was, what was that Mel Gibson movie where they're out in the desert and they're looking for gas and stuff?
Mad Max.
It was a Mad Max theme. I'm just...
Well...
Come on.
Well...
I actually went to the movies to see that.
Yeah, so did I.
Hated the Tina Turner one, by the way.
No, I was bugging.
I didn't like it.
The first one was the best one.
Here it is. This now this had a this don't come around here no more.
Yeah.
Guys, this is a really cool.
Right, yeah.
I love this song.
Right.
Hey! And the video is awesome. It had a what is it? God. What's her name in the tea party with the rabbit?
What?
Yeah.
Party. You lost me.
No, the girl that goes to the tea party, the psychedelics, what's his name, the Grimm Brothers or something?
Alice in Wonderland?
He had an Alice in Wonderland thing. He's in these tiny glasses, big head and hat, and he's looking at her and he's going in that. It's psychedelic. This whole video from MTV, I have to show it to you sometime when I got to pay my bill.
Right.
It's awesome, Steve.
Right.
Yeah. It's awesome. It really is. Like, it's one of the intrigue. Like, Johnny talks shit about MTV. I know you smashed it. But that's the era of when Bowie was making good videos. Tom Petty made a damn good video for this. Like, it's so good. Like, I can't even describe to you the Grimm Brothers theme he has for this. It's awesome. He's got the little girl, Alice, in a dress, and she just sees all kinds of stuff. It's cool, man. And he's like, he's not even really singing, he's like talking. And he's like, at this point, he's got a big teacup the size of this. That he picks up, takes a drink out of, sits it down, you know, it's psychedelic, it's great. This is during the era of even your rock groups doing good videos like God Rest His Soul, but Black Hole Sun from Soundgarden, you know, that was a good video, psychedelic, the black eyes, and, you know, it was good shit. Then you had Bowie doing a good video with putting on your red shoes and dance, you know.
Right, yeah,
that was great, man. I love that video and that song. No problem with me blabbering, I know, but I'm sorry. This is one of my favorites. The more I listen to this song over the years, and it's always been a good one. It's kind of like the Cars, the way this Rolling Stone Red guy said about the Cars.
Yeah.
The more you listen to it, the more you appreciate how complex and how good it is. The more I hear the song, the more I appreciate the complexity of him progressing, you know, to, it's awesome. That's just my opinion. Some people say they hate it, and that's good too, I guess. I love this blend. All their sounds came together right then. Great. With the sitar. You got the cockroach playing it, like 20 arms. In the video, a sitar with a big long stick cigarette. A sitar. Sitar.
Whatever.
I know, sitar. I want to say it correctly.
Right.
I don't say sandwich for Christ's sake, and I'm from here.
Right.
This is what I felt about Wendy.
About what? Sandwich?
No.
What are you talking about?
Don't walk. Don't come down my street.
Oh.
Will you?
Wow.
Do you expect me? Don't do it. It's dirty. And Melissa, for that matter. The blonde. The blonde from Texas. Me and her had a falling out. Yeah, recently.
That's not good, is it?
No, because my dookie level's getting to about the Sahara Desert level.
Right.
I'm in a dry spell.
Right, yeah. come. Well, it's always next weekend.
Wait, what? You're not a football team here. Yeah, there is. There's always tomorrow night. I'm optimistic, bud.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
I'm not that bad of a doctor. Plus, I'm a doctor. What lady don't want a doctor? Even if it is on Halloween night. So, look, you just, we'll go home and knock boots and you can tell people you slept with a doctor. So, there you go.
Yeah. No,
maybe Telly will be there. Yeah, man. I got a feeling Mars is wild as shit. His mom's really, really stoked. She's not feeling that bad. Chris is stoked as I'll get out buying a Moo Moo from Walmart.
I know.
And then he tells mom, I didn't tell you the kicker. What? You know how big Chris is like, oh, yep. This is a break. No, we got one more song.
Oh, 12. Oh, no.
So he tells mom, Mom, will you buy me some pantyhose? Make sure they're, make sure they're knee length. I'm like, good God, trying to cram your ass in a pair of nylon. It'd be almost hell to pay. So he's going all out.
Right, yeah.
That's going to be, if you guys knew my baby brother, he's the most opposite of any feminine thing you've ever seen in your life. So tomorrow's going to be great. We're always game to look like a fool. I was a wicked, demented nun near before last, and some drunk guy asked me 3 times to dance with him. Remember that? Yeah.
I wasn't there.
Yeah, he wasn't there. Actually, that's when Steve said something, because the guy was like going against the first song. And then when he said something again, Mom went and said something to Jeff. Jeff told Chris and Steve, and he said, if he says anything, if he gets up again, I'm nailing him, song or not.
Right.
And I'm like, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, so, and then Mom's like, well, I don't want no conflict. But what's his name? I just friended him on Facebook. My buddy, the bouncer at Micaiah's. He was in NASCAR before he got into Micaiah's. He went over there and politely, or not politely, escorted Sam. Him out. No, Sam, Sam's the bartender.
The bouncer.
No, the bouncer, I can't remember his name. I think it might be Sam, you're right. There's two Sam. You got Sam Stahl as the bartender, and then the other Sam is the bouncer. You're right. Then Logan as the bartender, you know. Yeah, but he was, see, he did something in NASCAR before. I didn't know, I gotta ask him tomorrow. But he got him out rather quick. He might be little, but I wouldn't mess with him. Jackass walked up and said, you a man or a woman? It's not my guy. You want to dance? I'm like, what are you fucking talking about? Well, I was like, oh dear Lord.
Well, I can only wait until tomorrow night with Chris.
Oh, it's going to be great.
Yeah.
And I can't wait to play with him. Bring another harmonica in.
Right.
We had a little faux pas day before yesterday. But
yeah.
And see, they would, and I don't expect them to notice it because they don't play. Steve's never played harmonica, but Jeff, nobody. Chris tried to hook up times my baby stop. But that's why he said that one night, y'all give it up for Eddie. He don't practice or nothing. And he shows up for the shows and he plays it like it's nothing. It is, it's not easy, man. But it's fun. That's the thing. If you can do it, it's fun as hell. Plus, I like to hear them, man. They're just good. Even if Chris wasn't my brother and I ain't doing nothing, I'd say they're good. I'm eclectic. I like matter of fact. I like mac and cheese or mac and juice.
That's it, buddy.
Yeah, taking a break.
You want to see?